Difference 24 hours can make here in the state of Kansas. Yesterday, a pretty good day, a little bit of cloud, but nothing like it is today, almost 20 degrees cooler for our Gardner Edgerton Trailblazers as they take on the Shawnee Mission East Lancers. Hello everyone, I am Chuck Holmes. I'm here with Coach Larry Purnell, and we're going to be calling the action for you here today. The Blazers are 5-0 after a walk-off double by Jake McClure, giving them a 5-4 victory over Shawnee Mission West yesterday. And the reasons why the Blazers are still undefeated, there are three of them. One, the first one is Hayden Dyer. Dyer homered again yesterday. Hit a two-run shot. First inning. Hayden is currently hitting 529. He's 9 of 17 with two home runs and seven RBIs. Here we're looking at Zach Sanford as he was able to close out Shawnee Mission West yesterday, only allowing one run on one hit and three innings pitched. Kept the Trailblazers in the game until they could score that winning run at the bottom of the seventh inning. And here we have Dyer hitting that two-run home run in the first inning. And as I mentioned before, he's hitting 529. He's 9 of 17 on the season, two home runs and 17 RBIs. He was able to get it up in the breeze yesterday to drive it out of here. And then there's Jake McClure. Jake had the game-winning hit yesterday. He's hitting 375, he's 6 for 16. He has six RBIs, and Jake has great patience at the plate. We see him rounding second here after hitting that game-winning double last night to bring in the winning run. We're currently up on a, we have gate keys to the game, pretty much like they were yesterday. But you know, we'll talk about those after we have our national anthem and the introduction of the starting lineups. We'll be right back after this small break.
All right, everyone, you made it.
My job is to help new homeowners who have turned into their parents.
I'm having a big lunch and then just a snack for dinner.
So we're using a speakerphone in the store. Is that a good idea?
One of the ways I do that is to get them out of the home.
You're looking for a grout brush.
Did he ask for your help?
No.
We all see it. We all see it.
He has blue hair.
Okay.
Blue.
Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Keep it coming.
You don't know him. We're at the movies and we need to silence our phone. Who knows where that button is?
I don't have silent.
Everyone does, right up here.
It happens to all of us. We buy a new home and we turn into our parents. What I do is help new homeowners overcome this.
What is that, an adjustable spanner? Good choice, Steve.
Okay, don't forget, you're not assisting him. You hired him. If you have nowhere to sit, you have too many. Who else reads books about submarines?
My dad.
Yeah.
Oh, those are...
Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Look at that.
At Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
Welcome back to Gardner Edison High School, where our Trailblazers are about to take on the Lancers from Shawnee Mission East. Just before we went to our break, we're going to talk about the keys of the game. And first key to the game was to stay hot. Trailblazers are hitting 328 as a team with a 512 on base percentage and a 513 slugging percentage. So they aren't missing the pitches when they're supposed to hit those pitches, and they're driving good pitches and showing good patience. Second key is pitching. Team ERA is stellar 1.80. They've given up 8 earned runs in 5 games. The only thing that's really a negative of them is their the strikeout to walk ratio, 21 strikeouts, 17 walks. And in fielding, this team's only committed 2 errors the entire season. They have a 980 fielding percentage, and Buttash behind the plate has thrown out 3 of the 5 runners trying to steal against him. So he is a lethal weapon behind the plate. We're going to look at our starters here at first base. We'll start with the outfield first here. Out in left field will be Jake McClure. Out in center field, Ty Wood. Brandon LeCluse gets to start out in right field this afternoon. Over at third base, we're going to have Austin Bowie, Hayden Dyer, the shortstop, Carson Schrack at second base with Dawson Williams at first base. Tyler Buttash behind the plate, and Landon Turner on the hill. So Landon's a left-hander. Left-handed senior. Pitched the other night against Olathe North and came away with the victory. First pitch is fouled up and out of play for strike one. Well, Coach, this is your first game of the season. How you doing?
This is my first game out. It's nice and chilly like it's football weather. Opening pitch and the ball goes over the top of my head. I got to pay attention.
You got to pay attention. Your curveball in there for a strike. No balls and 2 strikes on the leadoff hitter, Bergkamp. Turner's 0-2 pitch. And that ball spanked to center field and just out of the reach of a diving Sheck. So, Lancers have the leadoff runner on. Here comes the shortstop, Moody. Schrack made a good effort for that, just out of his reach. Trailblazers come into the game 5-0, ranked number 2 in the state. First pitch is low, ball 1. Buttash doing a good job of getting on top of that. Lancers come in at 3 wins and 2 losses this year. That pitch is low. This one gets away from Buttash as Bergkamp scampers into second base. So that'll be another pass ball. Pitch is also low. This one gets away from Buttash, but not very far. Turf is a little wet. We had some rain earlier today, so on the synthetic turf, the ball is probably sliding instead of bouncing.
Yeah, that can pose a problem.
Big time for the catcher.
Especially for the catcher. Buttash is doing everything he can to block that ball, but it's just kind of sliding underneath him.
Man, that pitch is low for 4 straight pitches, and Moody draws a walk. Bring up the third baseman, Jones. Jack Jones at the plate for the Lancers. And here's the pitch. Curveball in there for strike one. As I mentioned before, Landon Turner last pitched on Friday, winning 11-1. Runners at first and second. Nobody out here for the Lancers here in the first inning. That ball bounces, hits Buttigieg in the back. He can't find it. Everybody moves up, and that one goes a wild pitch. So here in the first inning, Coach, the Lancers are threatening early.
They're threatening early. It looks like the pitchers are a little tight today and a little low, and trying to get the ball up a little bit, but in this wind, you don't want to get it up too high. You know, it's coming in from us.
It's coming from the north field, today.
And it's coming out of the north. It's brisk.
And that ball's popped straight back and fouling out of play. Now, yesterday, the wind was blowing out of the south, and the flags out in straightaway center field were just standing straight up out in the south, and the Trailblazers and the Vikings were able to get a couple up in that breeze and to drive them out of the ballpark. Mm-hmm. So today, ball gets pitched up, it's going to get knocked down.
Yeah, it's going to take a shot today. It's nothing that's going to be in the air. It's going to have to be a line drive.
There's a curveball, and Jones just gets a piece of it. Landon Turner hitting the count. One ball and two strikes.
Good for him to throw that curveball again, Chuck. Just keep it on the outside and the batter reach for it.
You'll find out that a lot of these Trailblazers pitchers have very good command of their curveball. There's a fastball, and it's going to be fisted right to the third baseman, Bowie. Bowie makes the catch. Runners stay where they are, and there's one out. Good pitch by Turner.
That was a real good pitch. You got him on the inside, and you know, on a brisk day like this, you get the ball inside on the batters like that and jam them up, and send shockwave through your hands.
He's feeling that one now. Even with the gloves on.
Even with the gloves on, it does not matter.
He's feeling that one.
That ball is cold and heavy. It hits that bat, and it just shocks everybody.
Here's the catcher, Will Brandt. Brandt takes a strike on the outside corner. See if Landy can't pitch himself out of this little jam he's gotten himself into. 1.80 earned run average, man, for these Trailblazers. The pitching staff has been phenomenal.
Right.
Another curveball. That was just out of strength, slow and outside.
Tuned in a couple days ago.
Yes.
Yep. You know, that was seeing that young man as a basketball player now. And I'm watching him. All right, I might have to.
And there's a ground ball to Schrag at first. He bobbles it, throws the first. Gets the out there, but the drives will run home. And the Lancers take a 1-0 lead. So Brandt with the RBI. Moody moves over to third. And that will bring up the center fielder, Emmett Hill. First pitch is in there, strike one.
That's that pitch that he's been looking for right there, Chuck. He's just been a little low on some of those other ones. And sometimes early on, you're just not as loose as you think you are and kind of pull on the tug on the ball a little bit.
Takes a lot to get loose in there. There's a curveball, strike two. And Hill doesn't like that call. He thought it was a little bit high.
Just a little bit, but I am not the umpire.
No ball and two strikes. Here's the 0-2 pitch. That's going to be high. As you can probably hear, the wind is really blowing. Of course, it blows out here at Trailblazer Field. There's a curveball. It's going to be hit to Bowie at third. Bowie comes up with it. throws across the diamond and just gets the runner. So at the end of one half inning, it's the Shawnee Mission East Lancers 1 and our Trailblazers coming to bat. And welcome back to Trailblazer Stadium here, where the Trailblazers come to bat in the bottom of the first inning, trailing the Shawnee Mission East Lancers 1-0. I'm going to go with our lineup here for our Trailblazers here on GEHS MSTC Sports. And we see Ty Wood in center field. He'll be started off with the Trailblazers. Ty homered yesterday, hit a two-run home run. Number two will be Jake McClure. Game-winning RBI last night. Hayden Dyer, Walker homered yesterday, followed by Landon Turner, Austin Bowie, Tyler Buttash, Dawson Williams, Brady Lecluse getting the start in right field, and Carson Schrack. So this is the Trailblazer lineup. Some potent bats inside there, and these guys are patient, and they know how to hit the baseball. So Shawnee Mission East. The pitcher on the hill. Be Will Bollinger. First pitch swinging is Wood. Wood hustling down the line and the throw got him just so one pitch and one out.
You know, as I was walking in, Chuck, I was watching the young man warm up with this wind. I could hear it just sizzling through the breeze and reminded me of old times. That was, you know, first pitch, first hit. Sometimes it's good to jump on that first pitch. That's normally a pitcher's best pitch.
Yep. Jake McClure coming, lefty versus lefty. Jake's hitting 375 on the season. As I mentioned, he had the big walk-off double last night to give the Trailblazers the victory over Shawnee Mission West 5-4.
That's a good off-ball hit, too.
And that pitch is high. Ball two. Jake's one of those very patient hitters, extremely patient. And he takes a strike there. And there's a little tap at the short. Jake hustling down the line. Shortstop comes in, and not in time. The ball gets away, but it's being backed up by the pitcher. By the catcher, or actually the second baseman doing to back it up, and the catcher. So good fundamental baseball by East on that.
Yes.
Jake hustling down the line.
Slow roller like that, it was going to take a lot to get Jake East.
Okay, here's Hayden Dyer. Dyer's home with the last two games. First pitch, swinging away. There's a drive to center field, going back, and center fielder makes the catch. So Dyer, looking first pitch fastball, got it and gave it a ride, but it gets this win, Coach.
Yes. This win knocked that ball down yesterday. That ball would have been at least off the fence. Today, that's just a routine out by the center fielder. It was a good hit, though.
Yes, it was.
So one thing about the Trailblazers, they see a pitch and they don't hesitate to go after the pitch that they think is there. So they take a swing at it.
They got a slugging percentage of, the team average is 328.
Yeah, that puts a lot of pressure on the other team.
And there's a pitch, and there goes McClure down to second base, and he's going to be out as he slid off the bag. So Shawnee Mission East takes care of the Trailblazers at the end of one. It is 1-0 Lancers.
Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
And welcome back to Trailblazer Stadium here with Coach Larry Fennell. I'm Chuck Holmes. Shawnee Mission East Lancers are here taking on our Trailblazers. Lancers currently lead 1-0 going to the top of the second inning. And the first pitch from Landon Turner is a strike. Third baseman to the first baseman, Gavin Bridge. Second pitch bounces just in front of the plate, so ball one. Here comes the 1-1 pitch. Pitch is high. Turner gave up one run. He had a wild pitch and a pass ball in the first inning, which we were talking about the different. Here's a curveball, it's just low. It's 3-1. We're talking about the defense behind him.
Yeah, we needed that defense in that last inning to get those runs out there. One out, two on, at second and third.
And there's a strike at the knees as Bridge does cardinal rule number one in baseball.
Never leave until the umpire has made his call.
Yep.
Umpires remember those things.
They sure do. Here's a full count.
If it's close, you're going to have a problem.
Here's the pitch. And that pitch is low. So now it's ball four as Bridge draws a walk. That's the second walk that Turner's given up.
He's not missing by much. He's just a little bit low. Not much.
Not getting that low strike today, looks like.
He's not getting that today. And you know, he may need to pitch to the wind. The wind is here to help him. It'll knock some of these things down.
That's true.
Get the ball up a little bit and throw some strikes. Make these guys swing.
And there's a ground ball to third. Goes over to second for one. First base. And he's safe. Hustle down. Boo does a good job of getting the runner at second base.
It was a good turn. Nice, sharp hit ball. Right to the third baseman. You know, Chuck, I wish we had this when we were young fellas.
No, we don't.
that dirt we played on was very unpredictable.
You had dirt?
Along with a few grass mounds here and there. And
all right. So,
didn't know where you played. The gophers around the outfield, and it's an angle waiting.
So Fountain now on first base after changing places with Bridge. One out. And a swing and a miss to the designated hitter, Mr. Lyerly, Wes Lyerly. Man, swing and a miss. So Lyerly goes down swinging. And here's the left fielder, Brady Friend. First pitch, a little high and outside for ball one. You might see East put a play on here if they try to get that runner in scoring position. With a left-handed pitcher on the hill, though, it's kind of tough to read that move.
It is dangerous.
Ball's low, and with Buttash behind the plate throwing out three of the five guys that are trying to steal on him, the scouting report's out on him. He will gun you down.
Yes. Yes.
Here's the 1-0 pitch. And a swing and a miss.
Made a few adjustments. The ball's up a little bit, yep. And the Lancers are swinging through it now.
Yeah, Turner's made a couple of adjustments. Two balls and a strike. Gets that one up. Curve just breaks a little bit outside. 3-1. You put the runner in motion, Coach? 3-1, two outs.
Not with a lefty on the mound, I don't.
And the pitch. Here's the fight off.
Last thing I want to do is get that runner.
Thrown out, going
front
of the
Thrown out from first to second or picked off.
Yeah, he'll be in motion now. Full count.
Full count. Oh, yes, sir. He's in motion now for sure.
And the throw over. Not his best move, just to let him know that, you know what, you're not going to get that big of a lead on me to run on 3-2.
I am thinking about you. Standing over there and I can see you. Just to let you know. If you have any intentions on running, I will throw it over here at you.
Yep. And here comes the 3-2 pitch. And that ball is slapped foul down the right field line. Like, Friend was late on that one.
Just a little bit. And here's an opportunity to run on the inside and see if we can get another shockwave going.
Here's the pitch. And he swings right through it. So Landon Turner comes back with two strikeouts here in the second inning and at the end of 1.5. It's the Lancers 1, the Trailblazers nothing.
Is to help new homeowners who have turned into their parents. I got into this because I was a sufferer. I turned into my dad, but I came back. And I'm here to help others come back. This is my baby right here. Dr. Rick, I'm becoming your parents. It came about where my parentology thoughts, I was coming up with so many of them, I thought, I don't need to just have this, the world should have it. So I just birthed it, you know, right out of me. Sometimes we have a victory and I relish those.
Probably need a hacksaw at some point.
Nope.
But most of the time we don't.
General rule of thumb with throw pillows, if there's nowhere to sit, you have too many.
Parentology is not an officially recognized field yet, but I think we're making strides in that direction. You just have to keep reminding them you are your own person. You're not your parents. You're you.
And welcome back to Trailblazer Stadium here with the Trailblazers trail 1-0. You're watching GEHS MSTV Sports. Landon Turner leading off for the Trailblazers. Takes inside for ball one. Landon had a big bunt yesterday as he tried to sacrifice the runner in the seventh inning, but ended up getting a bunt base hit.
Mm-hmm.
She made it first and second with nobody out, which set the table for McClure to do his thing. And ball two. That's the left-hander Bollinger having an issue finding home plate. Landon hitting .667 on the year, so. Ball inside, three balls. No strikes. Turner with all kind of speed. So if he gets on base, he will be a threat.
There's a lot of options at 3-0. You can swing away. You can take one just to see if the pitcher can get a strike in there.
I think he's taken. And he takes one right down the middle for strike one. Now he's got a hitter's count.
A couple days ago, Whit Merrifield took a 3-0 deep.
But he had to make a lot more money than landing this, too.
That is true. That is true.
And that pitch is inside for ball four. From Landon draws the walk. Becomes the Trailblazers' second runner of the game. Austin Bowie coming to the plate here. Austin's having a rough start to the season. He's only got one hit for the entire season. That one hit was big, though. He drove in three runs with it, but that's the only hit he's had. He's batting 077, so he's off to a really slow start. There's a foul ball. Strike one.
Sometimes you just run into a slump like that as a hitter. You just, a lot of different things happen.
Yeah.
Just not in a rhythm. You're not seeing the ball. There's many things that could happen.
Right now he's picking up the team with his glove over third base. His glove is too valuable not to be in the lineup. So
yes,
he'll get the bat going. As the weather warms up, so will he.
Oh, yeah.
Quick throw over to first. I think Bollinger has a pretty good move over to first base.
That's a pretty good one. That's a pretty good one.
Throw too many times and Landon will read you. Here's the pitch. And that ball's hit right to second base. Going to turn two. There's second base for one. Throw it back to first. Not in time as Bowie hustles down the line. So that's one away here.
Sometimes it just takes a ball that you can hit and get yourself on base and you get out of that slump.
That's going to bring up Tyler Buttash, catcher. Ball, they're going to catch Bowie off base, and the throw is there, and he's going to be thrown out. So that left-handed move catches Austin.
It looks like Austin was trying to read that move. He was watching that move while he was at the plate, and he thought maybe he had something.
Now Buttash at the plate, hitting 250. And he turns on one. It's got a little up in the breeze. Right fielder's making the call for it. The breeze is pushing it, and he's able to stay with it to make the catch. So after two complete innings, it's Shiny Mission East 1 and the Trailblazers nothing.
Chuck, as we
wind is picking up.
And we're back here at Trailblazer Stadium as the wind is really starting to pick up here. There's like a little bit of a storm might be trying to blow in, but we've got confidence it's not going to rain. And if it does rain, somebody's in trouble. Somebody's in trouble. Well, Trailblazers trail here at the top of the third inning. 1-0 to the Lancers from Shiny Mission East. Landon Turner still on the hill for the Trailblazers. Landon's walked two and struck out two. Back to the top of the order for the Lancers from Shiny Mission East. Patrick Bergkamp singled and scored his first time. Thank you. And the pitch. And Burkamp takes it for strike one. Burkamp's a built. He's built like a baseball player.
That he is.
Got some pretty good size on him. Ball bounces. 1-1 to count. Trailblazers came into the game with a 1.80 ERA. That's outstanding.
That is very good. That's really mowing them down.
That is. Foul ball on the left field line.
I was hoping the coach was going to show his skills off.
Yep.
Get in front of that one, but it's a little chilly.
Man, that ball's on the inside. Two balls and two strikes. You know, one of the things the Trailblazers pitching staff really needs to improve on is their strikeout-to-walk ratio. Mm-hmm. And they're just about average right now. And there's Burkamp reaching. Bowie comes up with it. Long, strong throw and gets him over at first base.
Nice strong throw there by Bowie on a slow roller. Had to come in on that ball. Ordinarily, if this was the real stuff, that ball might have come at him a little faster. But
yep.
This damp turf just kind of killed that momentum of that ball.
Well, he just proved why he's still in the lineup.
His glove
and his arm.
Exactly.
His glove and his arm, so.
It's a good read on his part.
Here's the shortstop, Moody. Moody hits one. His left center field is coming in. McClure's running, and able to dive and make the catch. Nope. Oh, they called him out. He did make the catch.
Looks like there's a little hubble bubble left on the field there.
Was this bubble gum that came out, looks like.
The ball was snow cone, buddy.
That was a great running catch by McClure out there in left field as he was fighting the wind. And
yeah, that wind was knocking that ball down as it was. You know, on a day like yesterday, that ball would have came right to him.
Yep.
Today, he had to go get it.
Jones at the plate now. And Jones' first pitch swinging. Hits one to straightaway center field. He crushed that baseball, and it's off the wall. Wood able to get it. Makes a strong throw back to the infield. So Jones turns on one. Strong kid hits it into that breeze. One hop against the fence.
He gave that ball a ride. That ball was on a rope.
No doubt it would have been out here yesterday.
That was a tough read for the center fielder with the ball coming right at you like that. A gray sky and the ball. And it's kind of hard to pick that ball up sometime in this type of weather.
There's the catcher, Brent, now at the plate. Brent grounded out his last time up. Got a runner second base and two outs.
Concentration should be on this batter. Let's get this guy out. Don't worry about that run on second base.
Curveball right in there, strike one. You know, from our vantage point, Coach, you can really see the ball snap on that curve.
Yes. The angle that we have, we can see exactly when it's going to move. We can see the seams.
Yep. There it is again.
It's got a good rotation on it. Yep. You know, if you look close enough, if you're a good hitter, you'll be able to see the dot on the side of the ball. It's not on the front of the ball, which makes it tougher for the batter to see. It's easy for us to see that dot on the side of the ball because we're at a little angle here, but that batter, it's hard to pick that up.
There's a fastball. A little high.
Yeah, he kind of wanted that one. He got it letters high.
Two balls and a strike on the catcher, Brent. Here in the top of the third. Two outs, runner at second base. And the pitch. Line right to Bowie and then eats him up. McClure comes up. And he gets by McClure. So the runner will score from second base. So that's going to be an error on McClure in left field. As Brent is able to sting one down the line and ate Bowie up at third base. And advanced to second base on the air.
You say that ball was hot, Chuck.
Yeah, he stung it.
It hit that turf, and you can see it slide. When it hit that turf, it took a nice little slide and just kind of threw Bowie off a little bit.
That ball got there in a hurry on him.
Yeah, that's one of the ones the coach We'll say, hey, you need to get in front of that and take it off your chest. It's easier said than done.
That ball was hot.
It's cold out here.
That brings the center fielder Hill up, and Hill hits it off the end of the bat for strike one. He grounded out to Boyd last time over third base. Second pitch is high. Yeah, Coach, that's easier said than done. It's cold out here. You take that shot. But you know what? They're young men. They can handle that punishment.
They can handle it. It's only going to hurt for about 20 minutes. Yeah, it'll be over with it. Yeah. Have a battle scar to show each other when they're in the locker room. That's right. Man, look what I did today.
Ball inside.
I understand what he did. Yeah. That was a business decision.
The ball that hard hits me in the chest. My heart stops beating.
Or at least skips.
No, it stops. Three balls and a strike here to Hill. It's Turner trying to get out of this inning with just one run being scored. On deck at the first baseman Bridge for the Lancers. Three balls and a strike. Runner at second base. Run in here. The Lancers lead 2-0. And that pitch is strike. So we have a full count.
It's an important pitch.
You want to get this guy here.
I don't want to fall too far behind. I mean, 2-0 is not, it's nothing for a Trailblazers bats, but a day like this, you just never know.
And here's the full count pitch, and he pitches high and inside, and the good runner goes to third, and they throw the ball away as he surprised Buttash with that. And the run's going to score from third base, and the runner at first goes into second base, so another error here in the inning.
It's two errors and two runs.
Yep. That error is going to be on Buttash. As Hill moves up to second base on the throw. Well, we talked about the Trailblazers only having committed two errors coming into the game. They've equaled that already in this half inning.
They've equaled that. They just need to, still early in the game, and settle down a little bit. Concentrate on this batter here and get this guy out.
That pitch is a strike. I think what happened, I think he surprised Buttash in that ball four. The runner just took off for third base.
Yeah, that's surprising. As a catcher, you wouldn't think someone's going to take off on ball four like that. And with a runner going down to first. Yeah. And
that ball has popped out off to the right side and foul. I didn't catch the pinch runner. It was a pinch runner for Brandt, the catcher, after he had already singled. He had a pinch runner to come in, so.
Did not catch that.
Or the designated runner. I didn't catch it.
Designated runner. So.
Obviously, he had some speed. He had some confidence in his ability to steal a base, too.
That he did.
That's one of those, if you get thrown out going to third on the ball four. Yeah.
That wind is really whipping now.
You have a date with the JV team when that happens. One ball and two strikes here to Bridge, the first baseman.
Send them down for some work, huh?
Indeed. And here comes the pitch, curveball, got him. Yes, indeed. So, Lancers pick up two more runs here in the top of the third. They currently lead 3-0. Here at Gardner-Edgerton.
At Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
At Children's Mercy, we know that trust is everything.
And you can trust that we will do whatever it takes to protect the health and safety of your child.
Especially now. So we put our plan into action, implementing safety measures at every step of the way.
Whether it's technology that allows you to see your doctor from home,
or carefully planning out every visit so you'll know what to expect.
Because we want you and your child to feel safe at our home, too.
We're back here at Trailblazer Field with the Trailblazers lead, trail 3-0, Shawnee Mission East Lansing. Coach, Trailblazers only have one hit so far.
Yeah, we could turn that around in this inning right here.
Dawson Williams at the plate, the first baseman. And Dawson swinging on the first pitch, pops it up in the right field, is going to drop as the right fielder got a real late start on that. I don't think he saw it off the bat.
No, that was a CNI single, as we call it. It was going to be tough for the second baseman to get out there. And it was just hard enough into that wind that the wind helped keep it from going too far to right field.
Dawson needed that. He struck out three times yesterday, so he needed that hit.
Get him going.
Lecluse at the plate. Lecluse swings and misses for strike one. He's a right fielder. They're back over to the first place. I thought I was coaching for a minute. Oh, man.
You know, I have to routinely remind myself I'm on the microphone and don't start yelling things out.
And Brady takes that on the outside corner for strike two. For strike one, yeah, strike two. Two strikes.
It's an involuntary reflex.
Ball's outside. I'm thinking if my old eyes sitting over here and can see the move to first base, I'm sure those young guys can see it. Ball's high. 2-2 on the right fielder, Brady Lecluse. Trailblazers trying to get something started here, trailing 3-0 here in the bottom of the third. And Williams able to get back to first base. And Brady swings and misses, striking out. Went away, and that's going to pick up Carson Schreck. Carson Schreck. Carson's one of those guys. He can surprise you with a little bit of power. Once again, Williams back in safely.
Yeah, I've learned that in baseball, a slight of build does not mean you can't hit.
That's true.
It's about bat speed and timing.
He's only hitting 214, but he's very, very patient at the plate. He's drawn four walks. Takes ball one there. And that pitch is right in there for a strike. Trailblazers had yesterday with the left-hander Morrow from Shawnee Mission West. He threw a very good game yesterday, the left-hander. There, he struck out seven before the Trailblazers finally figured him out getting the seventh. And that ball's popped up out to the left field. Left fielder coming in, makes the catch, and it's two away. Ty Wood, the switch hitting Ty Wood comes up. He had a home run yesterday from the right side against the left-hander.
Right now, we'll just take a single. So move that runner. Advance that runner to the next bag.
Yeah, Bollinger's really concerned about Dawson over at first base, about Williams over at first base, Dawson Williams.
Yeah, that's I don't know if it's so much he's worried about Williams as he's just trying to throw Wood, Ty Wood off a little bit at the plate, throw his timing off a bit.
I don't know. If he loses concentration, Ty will take him deep.
Mm-hmm.
Gets his wind on him. And he takes a swing there for strike two. Ty down in the count. No balls and two strikes. Trailblazers trail 3-0 here in the third. Runner at first base, Williams. Here's the 0-2 pitch. And that pitch is outside. Ty grounded out his first time. Grounded out to third. And that pitch is in the dirt. Two balls and two strikes. Well, this is the pitch the pitcher wants. Bollinger wants this pitch. He doesn't want to go 3-2.
No.
Put the runner in motion.
No.
And that ball hits him. Hit him on the elbow. And Brady takes it off the inside elbow.
We can hear the little slight tink here. It almost sounded like the bat.
On the inside here as he just hits him on the bottom of the elbow.
Barry Bonds him a little bit. Kept the elbow out there.
Jake McClure at the plate. Jake singled his last time. Thrown out trying to steal second. And Jake takes strike one. And Jake with the game-winning double last night. That pitch is high.
Oh, it's always amazing. All that space on the baseball field, and the ball always finds a body.
And the pitch is popped up. In the foul territory, third baseman making the ball drifts back into fair territory, and the third baseman makes the catch. So, at the end of three, Shawnee Mission East 3, Trailblazers nothing.
When it comes to higher education, Johnson County Community College delivers more for your money. More opportunities to learn outside the classroom, more interaction with caring instructors, more personalized attention with supportive student services. Discover more at JCCC. Change your life through learning. Change your life at Johnson County Community College. Call 913-469-3803 or visit jccc.edu to learn more.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Adam Winters, the Kansas Highway Patrol. The Kansas Highway Patrol public resource officers across the great state of Kansas have a message for you.
3 out of every 4 car seats are installed incorrectly. Please read your owner's manual and vehicle manual to learn how to install your car seat correctly.
When driving on Kansas highways and you see a trooper in a safety vest and you see the orange cones, you're in a construction zone. Please remember, slow down, don't drive distracted, and move over. It's Kansas law.
Now that you've seen us, make sure you see us and all other first responders and road workers. Move over.
And we're back to Gardner Edgerton Stadium here in Gardner Edgerton, Kansas. I'm Chuck Holmes here with Coach Larry Fennell. You're watching GHS TV on MSGC Sports. Right now, Trailblazers trail Shawnee Mission East 3-0 going into the top of the fourth inning as Landon Turner still on the hill. Right fielder Fountain will lead it off for Shawnee Mission East. First pitch from the left-hander is a strike.
You know, Chuck, it'll do us good if we can get a 1-2-3 inning out of here and come back in the bottom of this inning and get at least one run.
That's true.
Wake ourselves up a little bit.
Second pitch is high.
Sometimes when you have walk-offs like that, it can linger. It's not always in a positive way.
Well, this is their third game since Friday in, 6 days?
Mm.
Curveball pulled foul on the left field line.
Be a little mental hangover there. No time off. But these young men are young.
Well, yeah.
You know, they're young. They should. They play a sport that plays a lot.
Yep.
So you have to be ready for 3-4 games a week.
And swung on and missed. Landon Turner gets the strikeout.
It's just like that, there's one down, and get two more out of here. And come in and get these bats warmed up. Pressure on the Lancers.
Strikeout number four for Landon.
Look at that replay and outside, and just couldn't quite catch up with it out there.
Landon's finding his groove. That's three in a row he struck out. Mm-hmm. Man, there's a swing. Strike one. Lyerly, the designated hitter, struck out the last time. Ball taken on the inside part of the plate. Ball's tapped foul. Turner hit in the count, one ball and two strikes.
Turner stayed on the outside. You know, I've only seen him go inside just that one time when that jam hit down the third base. Staying outside for the most part.
Here comes the 1-2. Fastball high.
You just have to be careful. You stay out there too long. And normally your miss is going to be right over the middle of the plate.
Yes. Yes, indeed. Which is not a good place to miss. And the curveball didn't break for him.
If they like this, it may help out, though. That wind to help you.
Yep. So now it's a full count.
As we saw earlier, though, there was one driven to 375 straight away.
That's right. Well.
It was hit on the rope.
And there is the pitch. Going to be fouling out of play. Soccer practice is over, so no one's going to get hit over there. Here comes a 3-2 pitch again. And that ball is fisted out to center field. Woods there waiting on it. And he takes it in for out number two.
That's what you need to do. He came inside that time. The batter wasn't able to get those arms out there and stretch out. Routine fire ball to center field. Squeeze it, throw it in, two outs. Let's get this last one here, Chuck, and get in there and get these bats warmed up. And give our crowd something to cheer about right now. That's a little chilly.
Left fielder Friend takes the first pitch for a ball. Second pitch swung on and missed. Friend struck out his last time up.
Yeah, he gave him three straight fastballs.
Sure did.
Struck him out.
And that ball is fouled straight back to the screen. Strike two.
Too. This is a pitcher's pitch.
Ball high. 2-2. And that ball is smoked back up the middle. Base hit. So Friend finds himself with a single. That takes us back to the top of the order. And Bergkamp comes up.
He squared that one up, Chuck. That ball was a knuckleball coming out of there. That means you squared it up.
Yep. Every time you hit it straight back up the middle, you're right on it.
You're right on that ball. That ball was, you can see all the seams on that one. It was
Bergkamp
slow
is one
dancer.
Bergkamp one for two. He singled and scored in the first inning. Grounded out in the third. Curry starts him off with a curveball, so strike one. Well, Lennon hasn't had a 1-2-3 inning yet. Fastball hit on the ground. Bowie comes up with it, goes to second base for the out. So after 4.5, Trailblazers trailing 3-0. See if we can't get the bats going here, Coach. Get them warmed up. We'll be back after this short break.
My job is to help new homeowners who have turned into their parents.
I'm having a big lunch and then just a snack for dinner.
So we're using a speakerphone in this store. Is that a good idea?
One of the ways I do that is to get them out of the home.
You're looking for a grout brush.
Did he ask for your help?
No.
We all see it.
He has blue hair.
Okay.
Blue.
Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Keep it coming.
You don't know him.
What will do it?
What will turn today's questions into tomorrow's answers that unlocks the mystery of rare childhood diseases? Love will, because love has no limits. And at Children's Mercy, neither do we. With leading researchers working to find the next advancement that will change outcomes, change lives, and change the world. Children's Mercy. Love will.
And welcome back to Trailblazer Stadium here. Chuck Holmes with Coach Larry Fennell on GHS MSTC Sports. Watching our Trailblazers currently trail Manson's from County Mission East 3-0. Left-handed Bollinger still on the hill for the Lancers.
Steve Hayes can't get it started off here.
Yeah. Bollinger's only giving up two hits. Like I said, yesterday the Trailblazers had trouble with the lefty, but they finally figured him out. Leading off for the Trailblazers will be the shortstop, Hayden Dyer. Dyer flat out to center field his last time. He's touching off with a curveball outside.
Outfield's playing pretty much straight up. Fielder shaded a little bit behind the shortstop, but for the most part.
The thing about Dyer is he hit the ball all over the field, but he's got great power to left center field.
If he can drive one down the line here, get it out there up the fence.
He'll run at least a two base anyway, but you know, they're definitely planning towards center. The left fielder's pulled over more towards center field.
Mm-hmm.
And that ball's popped up and out of play. 1-1 now. Trailblazer shortstop.
Protect the equipment over here, Chuck.
And that ball is smoked right to the left fielder. They had him play perfectly.
Played perfectly.
So hits it on the rope right to the left fielder. So Shiny Mission East living up to their scouting report on Hayden Dyer. Landon Turner coming to the plate now. Turner drew a walk the last time. Forced out at second on the fielder's choice. Lefty against lefty matchup here. Ball one. Landon shortens up the bunt, fouls it straight back, and it sits up on the screen, and the next roll off. Right over to Austin Bowie, who walks over, leans over, picks it up, takes it back to the dugout. One and one to count, Landon Turner. Curveball in there, strike two.
Yeah, and he knew it too at the last minute. He said, oh.
He's got some late breaking action on his curve.
It's a hitter's worst nightmare when you know after the too late.
And muscles up and throws that one high and outside.
It's only painful if it's third call strike, though.
That's true. And Landon pops that one up and out of play. I tell you, Coach, is it April turning into December or what?
Well, you know, I'm not quite sure. I just know that I should have put on a few more layers.
I was ready.
Quite sure.
Ball low. Full count. Landon Turner trying to become a base runner here for the Trailblazers to kind of get them started here. They trail 3-0 here in the fourth inning. Here comes the 3-2 pitch. And Landon hits one to the first baseman. Nice big old bounce. First baseman takes care of it. For out number two,
played a lot of softball back in the day, Chuck, and I can't remember any candy hops like that on a softball field.
No, this is synthetic turf, man. You're going to get that. So, you know, when we got here today, this place was really jumping. We had baseball on this field, we had baseball on the other field, the soccer, the softball team was playing, junior varsity softball. We had a track meet going. Soccer.
A lot of things happening.
A lot of things will be happening here on MSTC Sports, along with GEHS TV. We got varsity softball tomorrow night as Lady Trailblazers take on Olathe North. They'll be on live stream number 2. And there's Bowie takes the strike. 1-1 to count. Bowie into the fielder's choice this last time. Swung on and missed. Got a little pause. Small piece of it.
Just a little bit. Yeah. Just a little bit.
As we mentioned earlier, Bowie's off to a really slow start, so Coach Schracker staying with him, hoping his bat will heat up here soon. Mm-hmm. And he takes inside. Ball hits him on the knee.
Just brushed him a little bit.
Yep, just brushed him enough just to get the call.
If I'm not mistaken, he has to pay attention this time. He got picked off over there.
Yeah, he got picked off trying to go to second.
Yep.
Baldry was able to pick him off.
Reading the pitcher, yeah. Thought he had him. Was able to get him.
Takes a strike. Butash flat out to the right fielder his last time. 1-1 pitch. Man, that pitch grabs the outside corner for strike 2. 1-2. Take something off of that one. Slow roller to third. Third baseman bobbles a little bit, and he's going to drop the baseball, so that's going to be an error on the third baseman as he bobbled it, trying to make the transfer to go to first base. So everybody's safe.
That might be something we can work with too, Chuck.
That's what we need.
And we need a little luck on our side. And now we need a 2-out round.
Dawson Williams coming to the plate. Dawson singled his last time. Ball's in down low. Ball 1.
Couple of runners on. Give the pitcher something else to think about other than just the batter at the plate right now.
Single right here would be huge. And Williams hits one up into that breeze. He's got it nice. He hit it a long way. It's going. It's up against the wall. Williams hustling for second. 2 runs are going to come in to score. And just like that, the Trailblazers are right back in this baseball game.
Just like that, Chuck, that's exactly what we needed right there. That was a well-hit ball. As we know, yesterday that ball would have been out of the park. But
he hit that ball a long way to the opposite field.
You know, when he hit that ball, it sounded good here, but for my advantage, it was pretty high up in the air, and I didn't think it had enough to get past the right fielder, but it was just enough, and we're on the board now. It's down just a run now with a runner still in scoring position. The base hit here, and there's an opportunity to get another run in and tie this game up.
But that error really hurts the Lancers. They should have been out of the inning.
Yes. Yeah, we all know that error sometimes is followed by runs.
That's right. Now, Brady LaCruz at the plate. Takes ball 1. Well, Williams put a charge to that one.
He did.
He hit that heated better than I thought he hit it with the wind blowing in that direction, too.
Yeah, I'm looking at the center field flags, and they're blowing just a little bit to help the right field. If you hit that ball to right field like that, it's gonna travel a little further.
Williams, nice lead at second base. Ooh, LaCruz takes the strike.
Yeah, that's one you can't argue with. He's been out there all day, and he's been getting that call. So when you walk up to the plate, you got to know it's coming.
Base hit ties this game up. And, oh, LeCluse takes it on the outside corner. He's painting that corner.
He's touching every edge on it. Now you got to choke up and protect the play. Two strikes on you. Put the ball in play.
Ball's low. You know, Coach, when we played, it was, you know, when you got two strikes on you, you choked up on the bat.
Yes.
You know, you look at these hitters now, no such animal.
No. No, you see them in the major leagues every so often. You see those guys choke up. And you don't see it as much as we used to see it back in our day.
And that pitch is outside, so we got a full count now. Three balls and two strikes. Carson Schreck on deck. That ball's in the dirt. LeCluse draws a walk. Trailblazers now runners at first and second. Two outs, trailing 3-2.
For the first time today, Chuck, we see a little pressure on the pitcher.
Yes, indeed.
The air is kind of rattled and glances a little bit. And let's keep this rally going. We get a base hit here, and it's going to put some more pressure on it.
Schreck will show some patience here. Patience, he'll get the pitch that he wants. Baldur looking in, trying to snuff out this little rally that the Trailblazers have. First pitch is that inside for strike for ball one. Comes the 1-0 pitch. And it's in there for a strike. Ty Wood on deck for the Trailblazers, top of the order. Ty would love to come up with the bases loaded. Strike two for Carson.
Now he has to protect the plate at all costs. I'm the hitter. I'm thinking he's been coming inside all day. I'm going to look away, but protect the end.
Carson's choked up on the bat. And he takes strike three right down the middle. So Trailblazers are able to put two across in this inning on a big hit by Williams to drive in two runs, helped out by the error from the Lancers. So at the end of four, Shawnee Mission East 3, Trailblazers 2.
At Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
And we're back here at Trailblazer Stadium. Trailblazers able to score two runs in the last inning. Britton makes the score 3-2. A lot of upcoming events coming up this week, Coach.
Yeah.
Some more events. On April 13th, we've got softball. April 19th, more baseball here on GHS, MSTC Sports. Mm-hmm. And on April 22nd, more softball. The girls softball team, they are a power to be dealt with.
Mm.
So you'll get to see them tomorrow night if you tune in on GEHS TV. They'll be on live stream number 2 as they take on Olathe North. Talking to Coach Joanne Calvert over there, and she was telling me, she said, "Well, we're pretty good. I've seen nothing but excellence from those girls over there." So,
you know, as a coach, you always have to stay modest.
Yeah, she's sandbagging people. So Moody had to play for Shawnee Mission East, takes ball one.
Inside the dugout, you can say what you want, but outside, you got to be modest.
Curveball in there for strike one. Turner working on his fifth inning of work.
We see a few more clouds coming in here.
It's not going to rain, Coach. Not going to rain.
No, it's not going to rain. It's just bringing Moody, that cold wind.
Moody takes strike two. Moody's walked today and flat out the left field. And he gets caught looking for strike three.
That's a good pitch. That was a good pitch. You know, Landon's been out there all day with that pitch, too.
Strikeout number five for him.
They've had trouble since the second inning. The Lancers have had trouble hitting him.
It's Jones at the plate. Jones drove one to straightaway center field. Schrack comes in, throws the first, and he's out.
Good play.
Quickly two down here in the fifth inning. Expect Will Brandt to take a few pitches to give his pitcher time to rest a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Atlanta can speed that up by just throwing it right down the plate. Make him swing.
Make him swing.
Throw strikes. Speed him up yourself.
Ball one there. Curveball right in there.
Good pitch.
That's a late breaking curve as well. Brent singled his last time and scored as the Trailblazers committed two errors in that particular inning.
Mm-hmm.
Well, actually, he singled.
He singled.
But his designated runner.
His designated runner scored. By taking third on a ball four.
Yeah. And curveball just gets a piece of it.
You know, that curveball in this wind has a lot of extra movement on the end, on the backside of it. Even though that wind is blowing towards us, it's affecting the seams on that ball wind. It's making it break a little late into the hands.
Yep. There's a fastball swung on and missed, and Buttash puts the tag on him. So, after four and a half, Trailblazers trail 3-2 with a strikeout here.
What is Coca-Cola? Is it an excuse to get together? Since 1886, Coca-Cola has been passing on smiles from generation to generation. We've been giving kids scholarships, like the early birds and the all-nighters. And you get to enjoy what matters most. Coca-Cola. Drink up.
Your whole team can see your upper thigh. Pour that smooth roast and aim that camera up high.
The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
We're back here at Trailblazer Stadium. As Trailblazers currently trail the Lancers from Shining Mission East 3-2. Blazers able to push a couple of runs across the last inning as they're able to get to Bollinger, the pitcher. Trailblazers is kind of notorious in doing this. They'll see his burst a couple of times before they get to him. So we'll see how that works out since they are starting off here at the top of the inning with top of the inning with the top of the lineup as Ty Wood comes up.
This is our
Ty's 0-1. He grounded out in the first and was hit by a pitch in the third.
This is the third time through the lineup.
Third time through the lineup for him.
So they've seen everything he has to offer. There's not much he's going to be able to change that they haven't seen yet.
That's true. Ty homered yesterday. He hit one up into the breeze yesterday up left field.
Mm.
And when he hit it, he knew it. He gave a little bat flip. Yeah, he smoked it. Now he's just hoping to get on base here.
Yeah, it's important to just get on base right here and start this inning off right.
And he takes outside for ball one. And Ty gets under one, hits it out the left center field, right center. Center fielder makes the call, brings it in for out number one.
Yeah, just got under that one just a little bit.
Just got under it.
The left fielder, number seven, Jake McClure.
Jake McClure coming up. It's one for two. Singled in the first. Flat out to the third baseman in the third. And takes high for ball one. And he takes one right down the middle for strike one. Jake's one of those three-sport athletes we talk about, Coach.
Yeah.
And he takes that one at the knees for strike two.
You know, I was just talking to my son yesterday about that. I said, these guys are no break. This is the way we did it back in the day. You don't see that a lot.
And it's a little curveball, a little slow roller. Second baseman hustling in. Jake's running hard, and he beats it. It's a good play, good hustle
that
by Jake McClure.
That is good hustle.
He hustles down the line on a slow roller to the second baseman. Once it got past the pitcher, it was going to be trouble.
You can see that ball was dying. Bounce. We take a look at this replay. Watch this ball. It just kept dying each time. Second baseman was coming in. And so bang, bang.
Jake's got his head down, and he's hustling. So that brings up Hayden Dyer.
And that gives the pitcher something else to think about. There's a guy that's got some speed on first base, and may make that pitcher think about the pitches he's throwing down. And you not see too many slow curveballs now.
Jake's already been picked off once over there. Got thrown out trying to steal second. Dyer takes one at the knees for strike one. Yeah, Trailblazers, just the guy you wanted to play.
Yeah, if he can pick out that curveball, that slow curveball in this wind, he can give himself a couple extra steps.
He can find a gap somewhere. McClure will score.
Mm-hmm.
And throw over to first base again. Trying to keep McClure close, knowing that he's a tying run.
Yes. Smart baseball. You got to keep that guy real close and get around here and score on you.
But at the same time, you can't lose your concentration against Dyer because Dyer will take you deep. You lose your concentration, you'll lose the ball game.
He'll send you for a ride for sure.
Two strikes on Dyer. He fouls one off down the third baseline. He goes into protection mode.
Mm-hmm.
Chokes up a little bit on the bat. Throw over to first base again. McClure back standing up this time. And there's going to be another slow roll in second base. They're not going to be able to turn two on this. And the second baseman bobbles the ball for an error, and Dyer is able to beat it out.
That's two slow rollers, Chuck.
Two slow rolls, an error on the second baseman on that one.
As slow as that ball was rolling, you might have served with it. Just trying to pick it up with your bare hand. I know it's cold out here, but sometimes that glove and hit on that heel.
I tell you, they've had two well-placed slow rollers.
Mm-hmm.
Once they got past the pitcher, they became real trouble for the second baseman because he's playing up the middle, playing deep.
Mm-hmm.
Trouble is been able to take advantage of that.
That replay right there is right off the end of the bat, too.
Yep. I mean, he has no chance. Even if he makes that play, I don't think he has a chance.
He was going to be bang bang if he did.
Dyer's hustling down the line. There's no way he's going to get McClure at second base for sure.
No. Mm-mm. No, that one's not going to happen for sure.
No. Okay. Here's Landon Turner, the pitcher. Opportunity to help himself.
That's right.
Takes high for ball one.
You know, we just had a guy the other day that threw a 101-mile-an-hour fastball and hit a 435-foot home run.
Comes in fast and goes out faster.
I said, this guy helps himself. He's striking folks out with the heat, and he's sending them deep.
Ohtani, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's who it was.
did in the same inning.
Yes.
That's the summer when you can throw 100 miles an hour and take one out of the park at 107.
Yeah. You know, I've always been, always didn't understand that. You know, you see these guys come out of college as pitchers and hitters, and then they go to the pros, and all they do is pitch and never hit.
Yeah.
And a lot of them were excellent hitters in college.
Yep.
Unless they go to the National League. The
ball's high and tight. But even then, they're making their bread and butter by pitching, so they don't get a chance to hit that often. People like Zach Greinke, who love to hit.
Mm-hmm.
He loves to get up to the plate.
There he is. He was a hitter.
Yep.
And you couldn't throw him any junk up there. He knew what was coming.
3-2 here in the fifth inning. Trailblazers threatening. Runners at first and second. Nobody out. Well, one out, I'm sorry. Landon Turner at the plate, trying to stay out of that double play. And he takes a strike. Strike one. There's a big hole on the left side of the infield, Coach, between third and short. The shortstop's playing more up the middle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's hard to hit as a lefty and a left-handed pitcher throwing the ball inside. That's a hard place to place that ball.
And he takes that one away.
Takes a lot of discipline as a hitter to be able to hit that ball to the oppo like that.
3-1's the count. Hitters count. And it may be taken. Just to see if he can throw a strike across the plate. He won't mind going 3-2. Here's the pitch. And that one's low and away. Now the bases are loaded.
Bases are loaded.
And here comes Mr. Bowie.
This is a great time for Bowie to come out of this slump.
This is the time for him to come out of that slump.
This is an excellent time for him to come out of that slump.
His last hit, the bases were loaded, and he hit a double, drove in all three runs. That's the only hit he's had all season.
If I'm over there as a coach, I'm telling you, put your foot in there, take a deep breath, swing away.
And show some patience here.
Don't hesitate, swing away.
And he takes that one inside for strike one. Butash on deck. Austin wants to do right now to stay out of the double play.
Yes.
Infield's at double play depth, in at the corners. Pitches outside. Ball's hit the first to third. They're going to try to come home with it to cut off that run. If it's mm-hmm. up the middle, they're going to try to turn two.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that ball hits him, and that is an RBI.
And that's a tie game.
That's taking one for the team right there. And you know what? That's the second time he's been hit in two plate appearances. So if you can't hit the baseball, let the baseball hit you.
Hey, any means necessary.
Watch the hit. Yeah, hits him right in the wallet.
So, you know, he's a high schooler, so there's probably no money in that wallet.
Really? So I don't know, man. Days are different now. Butash at the plate now with a chance to give the Trailblazers the lead. And he takes it inside for ball one. Bollinger was cruising along there until a couple of slow rollers passed him in the second base and in an error.
That error has been on the road since the error.
Man, Butash swings and misses.
Sure, he was looking for, but he was out in front of that fastball, that's for sure.
I just got word that the official score didn't provide an error to the second baseman on that slow roller by Dyer.
Gave him a hit, huh?
Yeah, chances, and he probably wouldn't have been able to make the play anyway, so we'll give him a single on that.
That's right.
And besides, it helps Dyer's average.
That's right.
He's only hitting .538. Butash takes it high. 3-1. Bollinger's in real trouble now. And this is kind of what happens in high school baseball when you have a short of arms. You don't have a – you kind of got to ride with the horse longer than you really want to.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if he can get out of this inning with no more run score, then he's done his job as far as the coach of Shawnee Mission East is concerned. But if he gives up a big one here, then
he's
got issues.
Yeah, he's in a tight jam right now, 3-1. And One out, bases loaded.
And there's a shot right to the shortstop. And he's able to get back. Everybody hustles back to where they were going. So Buttash puts a good swing on it, hits it right to the shortstop that had him played perfectly up the middle.
Ordinarily, that's the perfect spot to hit that ball, too, right up the middle.
Right up the middle. But he had him played perfectly.
He had him played perfectly.
But Landon Turner, the second base alert. And Bowie hustles back to first. So. Williams takes strike one. Williams drove one to deep right center, right field last time for a double. Drove in a couple runs.
And the right fielder is playing that way along with the center fielder. He's playing a little deeper than he was last time.
And that takes that high swing.
He went after the high cheese. It looks good, but it's no good up there. No good at that altitude.
Oh, whoa, and he takes him out for strike three. Catches him looking. But the Trailblazers able to tie it up here in the fifth inning. So at the end of five, Trailblazers 3, Shawnee Mission East 3.
You may not hear it at first, but it's there. Echoing against limestone, drifting through the grove. You can feel it running deep beneath all that we are and do. More than a show of spirit, it's a source of energy. You can see it power leaders, fuel innovators, push dreamers into motion. On this summit, callings converge. Voices unify into a chorus, one that sounds out for good, for greatness. Our chant. Rising.
And welcome back to Edgerton High School, where we see Landon Turner still on the hill for the Trailblazers. Coach, he's settled down since the third inning there.
He has settled down, and, you know, he's mixed his pitches up a lot better. And, you know, we started off that game, he was really low.
Yeah.
And then he got the ball up and got a few strikeouts and an error hurt him. Ever since then, he's kind of settled in and put these Lancers on the heels.
Struck out two that last inning, so. Got six strikeouts for the game. And there's a bunt. Turner quickly off the mound to throw to first. Got him. Yes, indeed. As Turner quickly off the mound, turns and throws. Throws out Hill as he's trying to get a bunt single.
Yeah, he got off that mound real fast and pounced on that ball, got his feet set, took his time, made a strike, threw a strike to first base.
Now here's the first baseman, Bridge. He takes the curveball for strike one. And Turner's done a really good job of settling down, kept his team in the game until they can get their bats going.
Mm-hmm.
And that ball's going to hit on a rope to left field. Is McClure to reach it and throw it back in. So Bridge on with the single. Fountain now, the right fielder.
It's going to be important. I'm going to have to pay attention to the runner over there now. And if I'm the Lancers coach, I'm trying to get that runner to second as fast as I can. Put a little more pressure on him.
And there was a strike for Fountain for strike one. Fountain struck out his last time up. You're right, coach. He's trying to get him in the scoring position because he knows he's not going to give me any more opportunities.
Nope.
He's at the bottom, coming from the bottom of the order here, so. Curveball breaks outside. I mentioned earlier, Buttash has thrown out three of the five runners that have tried to run on him. He's throwing people out like he's a bouncer. Club.
You said you got to leave. It's time to go. I can't go home until you're out of here.
You ain't got to go home, but you can't stay here.
That's right. That's right.
Here comes the 1-1. Ball gets by. Buttash as the runner moves up to second base on a pass ball. So Bridge now in scoring position.
Yeah, he kind of landed, kind of tugged that ball a little bit, held on to it a little longer than he should have.
Single right here puts the Lancers back on top, possibly. Late swing on that. Had him completely fooled on that pitch.
He did have him fooled on that one. That was a good pitch, good location. Yep. He wasn't sure to swing away or to protect.
Two balls and two strikes now. Buttash giving the signals behind. And that ball is hit down the right field line. It is going to be a fair ball.
Fair ball.
Here comes the runner from second to score. And the Lancers are back out in front 4-3 on a double by Fountain down the right field line.
Yeah, Fountain just stayed with that pitch. It was a little curve outside, and it stayed out there, and he stayed with it. Put his front shoulder in and just went with the pitch. And you can see there, he stayed right along with that pitch.
So the pass ball comes back to hurt the Trailblazers. McClure bobbles it a little bit out there, but it's not an error because it's going to be a double anyway, and the runner probably would have scored.
Yes.
So Fountain's at second base now with one out for driving in the lead run. And that's going to be all for Landon Turner. Pitched a pretty good ball game, so as we're watching warm-ups, we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. What didn't cross your mind is why you scrambling for air times. The day you lost the battle was the day you lost your hairline. Ain't just gonna break your dog, I'll break your heart. Class is dismissed. Take this diss and depart.
Stop right there.
What?
Here, eat a Snickers. You always lose your edge when you're hungry. Better?
Better. Yo, I said, give me the track, I'm finna snap. You know, timid, I ain't that. Guess your memory got snatched and you forgot that you can't rap. Yeah, you need to get some money, you look broken. You couldn't catch no water.
You're not you when you're hungry.
I ain't knowing how I'm trash, you gotta tell me.
Snickers.
What you
mean. It's more holes in your...
Welcome back to Trailblazer Stadium, where we have a new pitcher on the mound, Garrett Bergman, right-handed junior, number 16. Actually, number 15 comes in with a runner at second base, one run already in. Trying to mention he's leading 4-3. Lyle at the plate, the designated hitter. He's 0-2.
We got to stop the flow right now, Chuck. We're in a situation where we can let this get out of hand real fast if we can't. This guy's important right here.
And he takes a fastball strike on the outside corner. Trailblazers coming to this game undefeated, 5-0, where the Lancers come in at 3-2. Trailblazers is number 2 in 6A in the state. Mm. That ball is turned on foul, way out in front of that slow curveball he threw up there. So Lyerly not in the hole. One ball and two strikes. Bergman, another one of those tall pitchers that the Trailblazers have.
Hmm.
He's a nice size. And the pitch. And Buttash does a good job of framing that pitch for strike three.
It was close enough that you don't take up two strikes.
That's right.
So the things I just tell the kids all the time, if you get two strikes on you.
So Berkman comes in throwing strikes.
Can't be selective like that. You gotta
look
go
at
swing.
This pitch. Buttash, look at that. Did he frame it or what?
He framed it. He definitely framed it.
And that ball is pulled foul down the third baseline. Coach over there doing a dance. Still light on his feet.
He's still a little nimble over there. I saw him get out of the way.
Friend at the plate. Friend's 0-1-2. Singled his last time. Struck out in the first and the second. Curveball just a bit outside. Once again, all these trailblazers pitchers have excellent curveballs.
They do.
They have pretty good command of them.
And they're not real tight, so they're not putting a lot of pressure on that elbow.
Right.
They're kind of like a knuckle curve. And this way they dance.
That one's hit right. Oh, that hits the umpire. That makes it a dead ball. And it goes to third, and he safe. That saved a run because that ball was headed up the middle.
It was headed up the middle.
And hit the umpire.
He will know that in about 20 minutes.
Yep. See it here as he comes off the mound and hits him right in.
He was trying to get out of there.
Hit him right in the arm.
It was hot. He was trying to get out of the way, though.
Sometimes you can't do anything about it. You just got to just take the shot.
You just got to take
it. So here we are at the top of the order again as Bergkamp leads it off here. We're going to have a timeout. Well, the umpire is going to
go check on his mate.
Check on his partner.
Okay.
See if he's all right. You know, that usually happens if an umpire gets hit by a pitch or a foul ball or whatever it is, then the catcher will go out and talk to the pitcher, you know, give the umpire a little bit of time. But if the catcher gets dinged up a little bit, the umpire, and I think they're going to send him back to second base because
it's a dead ball.
Because when that ball hit the umpire, it was a dead ball.
It's a dead ball when it hits the umpire.
Exactly. And I called it as a dead ball.
And he made an attempt to get out of the way.
Yep.
So, therefore, he penalized the.
Here it is again. He comes through here and he swings. And he can't get out of the way. And now the ball's dead.
That's a dead ball.
Yeah. I mean, it actually saved a run because that ball was headed out to center field.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to send him back to second base. Yeah, that's a dead ball.
It's a dead ball. Sometimes the fans don't like it, but fans also don't have the book in their pocket. Anytime that ball hits the official, it's dead.
Yep. In any sport.
In any sport. Basketball, if it hits the official and he's standing out of bounds, it's out of bounds.
That's right. And swung on and missed. Strike one to Bergkamp, who is 1-for-2 today. 1-for-3. He's grounded out to the third baseman twice.
Mm-hmm.
Single and scored in the first. And a pickoff throw to second.
It's just a little check with me. Make sure you're paying attention.
Comes the 0-1 pitch. It's going to be a ground ball to Dyer. Dyer scoops it up, long throw across the body, and he gets him. That's Bergkamp hustling down the line, unable to beat the throw from Dyer. So the Lancers score one run here in the sixth inning. And they currently lead 4-3.
My name is Ricky Gutierrez, and I'm from Eden Prairie, Minnesota. I'm an educational studies major, and I am hoping to go into school counseling. Earning a degree is important to me just because of the opportunities it opens for me for my future. I always knew I enjoyed working with kids, and that was something I was passionate about, and I originally planned to become a teacher. I realized I was more passionate about the kids and their upbringing and their development, and K-State actually offered a program that worked perfectly with my interests, and so I decided that school counseling was kind of the right path for me, just so that I could focus more on that psychology aspect and work with the kids on a more intimate level. plans after graduation are kind of, they're exciting because I have plans to get my master's degree in counseling. Hopefully I'll have to do that. But also just that experience of getting some real life work in schools, and specifically schools in Costa Rica. Half my family still lives out there, and I would love to go spend time out there with them and just to get to experience that culture and that lifestyle, and all the while still helping people and working with kids.
And welcome back to Gardner Edgerton High School, where we have a new pitcher on the hill. Trail for the Lancers. His name is Brady Friend. Friend comes in from left field to pitch, which means we also have a new left fielder.
Yep.
Can't see his number from here.
Number four.
The number four?
Yep.
All right, so Lowry goes from the DH spot into left field. So Lancers lead 4-3 as the Trailblazers come up here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Brady LeCluse lead it off for the Trailblazers. He struck out and walked his last time up. See if Brady can't get him started, get the Trailblazers back into this game here. And he's first pitch swinging, pops it up. Out of play, so strike one to Brady. And that ball is hit. Traveling towards the left field line. Left fielder is there, makes a strong run, and makes the catch.
That wind blew that ball at least 20 yards back into play.
Yep. So Lowry gets tested early out there in left field with the wind.
We'll see if Austin is first pitch hunting as well.
Here's the second baseman crossing Schreck. Schreck takes a curveball for strike one. Fastball, and Carson turns on one, hits it, got him a single out in right field. So, Carson's at first base, one out, brings the top of the order up as Ty Wood comes to the plate. Ty comes in, I've been hit by a pitch, he's 0-2 today, coming up on the left side against the right-hander. That ball's in the dirt. That bounces not too far away. Track didn't have any lead over at first base. In fact, he was standing on first base when the pitch happened. Now he gets lead. That ball's down low for ball two.
It looks like he's trying to keep this ball down and away from that power. Ty turns on one right here. Yeah.
That's one thing about the Trailblazers. When they get into the other team's bullpen, that's going to go right through. And Carson's going to keep going to third base on that. Right fielder comes up with it, throws the ball into second, and Carson hustles all the way around first to third.
That's good hitting right there. It's good hit.
Wood able absolutely to find a hole on that right side over there.
The ball behind the runner. Allow that runner to run first to third. See this replay here as he
turns on it.
Ty hits the ball behind where the runner's at.
Carson's already got his mind made up. He's going to third base.
Oh, yeah.
Running hard. No doubt. So a good piece of hitting by Ty Wood. Carson in scoring position with Jake McClure coming to the plate with an opportunity to drive him in. Jake had the game-winning hit last night against Shawnee Mission West.
Yeah.
He had a walk-off double.
He'll definitely have to be covered with Jake coming up here today.
Yes, indeed.
He hits one in that gap. That's two runs again.
Coach Gordon the Lancers walks off after having a powwow in the middle of the diamond with his infielders. Looks like they're going to be in at the corners, holding a runner on at first, and kind of double play depth in the middle of the infield. Outfield's deep, center field is deep. Throw over to first. And that's what you got to be careful of. If you pitch, you can throw the ball away over there real quick.
Yeah, he throw this ball away, and it's a tie ball game just like that. So you have to be, you have to watch out.
They also know Wood can run. And Jake takes strike one. You put a straight steal on here, Coach? With Wood over at first base, you got a runner at third?
Yes.
Make the defense make a play?
Yes. Pressure.
It's going to give Jake a chance to hit. Nice, 0-2.
Now you have to think about it a little bit. 0-2 count, one out. You don't want to get a bang-bang and two outs just like that. So,
well, you don't want a double play. You want to stay out of that double play, yes. That's for sure, because you got Dyer coming up next. And there goes Wood, and then Jake fouls it off. So that's exactly what Coach Schrack is thinking. I got my boy coming up, Dyer, and I want to stay out of that double play. And I got speed over at first base.
Yes.
So, and I got a pretty good hitter at first at the plate. I got speed at third base, so it's all set up for him. It's the way he likes it.
Jake might want to sit fastball.
And
there it was
inside.
Now he's going to have to look curveball.
Think about Jake. Jake's a good patient hitter. He knows what he wants. He very rarely gets caught looking. Very rarely gets fooled. But you want to stay out of that double play if you can.
Yes.
That's an inning killer. And line foul. Curveball.
He tried to wait.
Yep.
He tried to be patient.
He just couldn't hold on.
He just couldn't hold no longer. He was holding and holding. Yeah. Cindy.
Hold on.
You're only going to get one out of this.
Yep, you're going to get one. And we are tied up, now so McClure is able to do his job. So that's outstanding job by Jake.
And we still have a runner in scoring position. So
and there's two outs.
Lancers aren't out of the woods yet.
There's that pitch as Jake is able to pull the ball, hustling down the line. There's Dyer at the plate. Oh, big breaking curveball. Woo, that was a big curveball.
It was a big one. Dyer wasn't quite sure that.
Yeah, I'm not going to see if we can see that one again. Look at this.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a huge curveball right there. Bumped a lot of people's knees.
Yes, it will.
He's going to try it again. And he does it.
And he does it again.
Snaps it off again.
Yeah, that one's on the outside this time. He threw the first one outside, this one outside. And now that he has his eyes set and the speed in his mind set, he may come with a fastball here. Inside heat.
Oh, he got him on three of them. And that is, and Dyer's not happy with that. But the Trailblazers do come back and they tie it up here in the sixth inning with one run. At the end of six, it's 4-4. Shawnee Mission East and Gardner Edgerton High School.
What is Coca-Cola? Is it an excuse to get together? Since 1886, Coca-Cola has been passing on smiles from generation to generation. We've been giving kids scholarships, like the early birds and the all-nighters. And you get to enjoy what matters most. Coca-Cola. Drink up.
Your whole team can see your upper thigh. Pour that smooth roast and aim that camera up high.
The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
We're at the movies and we need to silence our phone. Who knows where that button is?
I don't have silent.
Everyone does, right up here.
It happens to all of us. We buy a new home and we turn into our parents. What I do is help new homeowners overcome this.
Was that an adjustable spanner? Good choice, Steve.
Okay, don't forget, you're not assisting him. You hired him. If you have nowhere to sit, you have too many. Who else reads books about submarines?
My dad.
Yeah.
Oh, those are...
Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Look at that.
And welcome back to an exciting ballgame here at Gutterton High School. I'm here with Coach Larry Fanilis. It's Chuck Holmes. You're watching GEHS-TV on MSTC Sports. Coach Trailblazer is able to come back in that last inning to tie it up on a field, on a sacrifice by, on a ground ball, I should say, by Jake McClure.
Yeah, that was that's exciting right there, you know.
Yeah, got some coming up, more upcoming events here as we look at on April 13th. Got softball, and April 19th there's also baseball here back on MSTC Sports. And April 22nd, more softball. So if you haven't seen the Lady Trailblazers play, you really need to check them out. They'll be on live stream number 2 and on those particular days. Or if the weather's even nice, come on out and watch them because they are one heck of a softball team. Games I've seen them play, Coach, they haven't allowed a run. Mm. They beat Shawnee Mission South 23-0.
Ooh, mercy. Mercy.
Three touchdowns and a 2-point conversion.
That's right. Somebody has a safety in there somewhere.
Yep. Bergman's back on the hill here at the top of the seventh inning for the Trailblazers, trying to hold Shawnee Mission East down so the Trailblazers can come up one more time in the evening. Got a new first baseman. Mitch Mock moves into first base. Yeah. They got Dawson Williams moves out to left field. Out there. Mm-hmm. Any more changes? I'm not sure if we do or not.
I think that's the last change there.
Well, Jake McClure moves over to shortstop. I think what you said, Coach, I think Dyer may have been thrown out for throwing his bat.
Yeah,
so he may have been thrown out of this game.
Yeah, the umpire doesn't take kindly to you tossing your bat that way. He just kind of turned and slung his bat a little bit. He might have got away with it, but he...
Yeah, he threw it across the diamond over there, so...
Took a couple of his teammates out with it.
Yeah, there's a foul ball.
Look out, Coach. Hot.
Moody at the plate, trying to lead it off here for Shawnee Mission East. The Lancers try to improve to 4-2. Here's the 1-0, the 0-1. There's a hot shot to Bowie down to third. Bowie comes up throwing. Got him. Oh, and he's going to say that he's safe. That was a bang-bang play over at first base.
That is
as
bang,
Moody was
bang.
Hustling down the line. And
Coach is going to come out and have a couple words.
Bowie comes out and makes a strong throw.
Let's take a look at this replay.
See if we can get the replay over here. And right when we get to the bag, we don't get to see it. So we have to take the umpire's word for it.
It was the wind's fault.
Coach is not very happy with it, but you know, we don't have replay here, so
that's not official.
That's okay.
We don't have the official replay.
Moody hustling down the line, able to beat it out. Give the young man credit.
He was hustling.
Third baseman Jones is at the plate. Jones hit a double back in the third inning. He pops this one up.
It's going to be
down the line. The wind's going to knock it back over. In. Jake comes all the way over to make the play. So good coordination in the outfield. But as you said, Coach, the wind blew it back into fair territory because that ball was fouled by a good 4 or 5 feet.
It was definitely fouled. That was yesterday. That ball is fouled.
We're going to see it again and get a replay. See how bang bang it was.
Catch this one down the line this time.
Oh, I think he's out. He's still in the air. There's the throw over.
Yeah, I think that's one that would have been overturned, and we'd be looking at 2 outs right now.
Instead, Moody's at first base, getting his lead. Bergman to the plate. Hot shot. It's going to be 2. There's 1 over to first base. Double play. Trailblazers able to turn the double play. And that's what they do. Their defense is so stellar that they can pull those double plays. So at
awesome.
The end of 6.5, it's the Trailblazers 4 and the Lancers 4.
At Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
At Children's Mercy, we know that trust is everything.
And you can trust that we will do whatever it takes to protect the health and safety of your child.
Especially now. So we put our plan into action, implementing safety measures at every step of the way.
Whether it's technology that allows you to see your doctor from home,
or carefully planning out every visit so you'll know what to expect.
Because we want you and your child to feel safe at our home, too.
And welcome back to Trailblazer Stadium. Coach Larry Fennell. I'm Chuck Holmes. Coach, we've seen a good one.
We are seeing a good one, Chuck. You got me out here today. It's cold and we're seeing a tight ball game.
Well, see, you weren't here yesterday. This is deja vu. Yesterday, we went into the bottom of the seventh inning, tied 4-4 with Shawnee Mission West. Trailblazers able to come away with a victory. Jake McClure was able to hit a walk-off double with Groh on second base. He was able to come all the way around and score on that. The Trailblazers walked off to remain undefeated, 5-4.
We're going to need another one of those today. And it's important to get the first runner on base.
Always important to get the first guy on. And Turner's the person to do it. You want a person on base with speed, Landon Turner can do it.
Mm-hmm. Use the whole field, Landon. Use the whole field.
So Friend back on the hill. Landon shortens up the bunt, takes strike one.
That's a good thought.
See, yesterday Landon was at the plate and runner at first base. Just trying to sacrifice him over the second, ended up getting a bunt base hit.
Mm-hmm.
Which kept him in the line, runner the first and second, no one out. Curveball hits him on the leg.
So that will change the complexity of the game right there. Now you got a runner on base and hopefully it doesn't hurt too long in this cold. It was a slow breaking ball, so let's take a look at the replay. And, right in the calf.
Right, yeah, he's limping a little bit down. He's trying to work it off. He's walking down the right field line out there.
That's smart.
He's trying to work that off. I don't care who you are or how young you are or how old you are. When it's, that hurts.
It hurts. There is no question.
Yes,
it hurts.
Oh, here's Bowie at the plate again. Bowie's been hit twice.
Yes.
He hit the last time he was hit, he drove in a run, which tied the score at that time, 3-3.
Mm-hmm.
Long overdue for a base hit is Bowie.
Yes, he is. It's always just a matter of time before a guy breaks out of the slump. Perfect time to do it right here.
There's a bunt. Foul. Now, that's something you didn't expect. I don't think the third base expected it, but maybe he did. I don't think he did, though.
I don't know.
He shortened up. He's playing in tight at third base, but he's expecting it now.
Mm-hmm.
Pulls a bat back. Takes ball one. Turner down there dancing around at first base. Got the catcher's attention.
This would be a perfect time to drag one. Drag that thing down first baseline and make that pitcher have to come off and make a play.
Coach Schrag over to give him some signals now. Pulls the bat back again. There's a throw down to first. He's back in there. Brant not afraid to throw it down there.
It's a risky proposition to throw that ball down there like that in a tight game like that. It gets away from him. That runner's going to advance two bases.
and Bowie able to get the bunt down. Good bunt. Throw the first base. Good job by Austin Bowie to advance the runner.
Good job.
Yeah, Tyler Buttash coming to the plate now. Runner in scoring position with the winning run in scoring position,
winning
I should
run.
Say.
Yes.
In high school baseball, we're playing 7 innings. Unless we're tied, we'll go extra innings. Buttash looking to end it here. Yeah, it takes low for ball one. Buttash reached on an error, but he's 0 for 2. There's a shot between second and third, and the ball was hit hard enough.
That was a shot, Chuck.
Landon can't score from second base, but Buttash turned on that one.
That was a shot.
The last time Buttash got to play, the bases were loaded. Remember, he hit that shot to the shortstop.
He sure did.
This time, he's able to find the hole over there. So now the Trailblazers. Winning runs at third base. They're going to automatically walk Williams. Williams struck out his last time, but he did hit a double once way out there to right field. So now the bases are loaded. Infield comes in.
Hey, that's what gets a force at any base right now. And play the percentages.
Middle of the infield is a double play depth. And pitch is high. To Lecluse, Brady Lecluse at the plate.
You know, this is a situation, Chuck, I haven't been in before that I've actually laid down a bunt, put one out. They're not expecting it.
You got speed. You got speed at third base. Trying to squeeze?
Yes, they're not expecting it. They're expecting you to try to advance these runners conventionally. You do something odd like that. Maybe not on the first two or three pitches, but you get a favorable count. One down. You got to make a play.
I think you make the pitcher pitch, do you?
I'm aggressive, Chuck.
I know. And that's why we're sitting over here. Brady takes ball two. Oh, possibly swung at ball three, but now it's two balls and two strikes. Like you said earlier, can't off that high cheese. It just looks so inviting.
It looks good.
Brady with a chance to give the Trailblazers another walk-off. Curveball outside. Count is full.
No place to put him. No place to put him. Expect something to hit.
Big pitch right here. Could be your ball game. Foul ball. Foul wave. Brady stays alive.
The time you tell your hitter. Don't try to pull it. Just put it in play.
Just make contact.
Make contact.
Take strike three on the inside corner. I just say, older coaches, when it's two strikes, it's too close.
It's too close.
Don't make the umpire make the call.
You got to swing.
That's right, because he's cold. He's ready to go home.
I am happy with you going down swinging than I am with you going down looking.
Here's that pitch. Right there on the inside part of the plate. He caught him belt high. Good looking pitch. He may have been expecting a curveball, end up getting a fastball on him.
Yep.
So here's Carson Schreck. Ball one.
You know, Carson had a solid single the last time up.
Single and scored.
If he duplicates that single, it's a ball game.
Carson has a very good eye, too. That ball's hit left field. The wind's going to knock it down, and it's over. As the left fielder misplays the baseball out of the left field, and for 2 days in a row, the Trailblazers do a walk-off in the bottom of the seventh inning. I tell you, when you're living right, you're living right. Coach, we're going to talk about it when we come back. Trailblazers win it 5-4. We'll be right back.
Look.
Chris. Take this diss and depart.
Oh, give it up for my man Grizzle. Up next, we got my boy Boogie. Give it up for Boogie. Let's go. Boogie, we got time.
Don't go breaking my heart. I couldn't
Boogie,
if
Boogie.
I...
Whoa, what? Stop right there.
What?
Here, eat a Snickers. You always lose your edge when you're hungry. Better?
Better. Yo, I said, give me the track. I'm finna snap. You know, timid, I ain't that. Guess your memory got snatched and you forgot that you can't rap. Yeah, you need to get some money. You look broken. You couldn't catch no water.
You're not you when you're hungry.
I ain't knowing how I'm trash. You gotta tell me.
Snickers.
And welcome back to Gardner Anderson High School, Coach, where the Trailblazers have walked off the second night in a row with a walk-off victory. And, you know, we were sitting here talking. It's so tough to come in off the bench.
It is tough
to negotiate this win. So Lowry had a tough job out there in left field because he hadn't been out there the whole game.
Exactly. It's tough when you play out there in that outfield and you're not out there for a while and the elements are out there. And, you know, ordinarily that ball would have continued to go to the left field line.
Yeah.
So well, with that win, he didn't play to win to bring it back to him.
Absolutely. Well, the Trailblazers did a good job of keeping themselves in the game. Pitching, once again, kept them in the game. A few errors here. But the play of the game is it's going to be a double, I believe it is.
Mm-hmm.
Off the, not sure off the bat of one of the players here. Let's see who it is. It is off the bat. No, it's going to be the double play.
The double play. There
yeah,
we go.
Yeah, the big double play to get him out of the inning. Started by Bowie over to Shrek. And then with Mitch Mark with the big stretch.
He needed so, all that 6-6.
So the defense was able to bail him out there to keep the game tied. And here we go with the player of the game because Carson Streck, you know, he's the coach's son. So now he gets to go home and practice the coach. Good
right.
call, coach.
Right.
This fly ball down the left field line. It is hitting pretty well.
And
but the left fielder playing the...
Yeah.
He, playing, just, he just misplays it.
He just misplayed it. He should have floated to the ball instead of running to the ball.
Check this out as he crosses home plate. Look at Turner. Take that. We'll take it. We'll take it anyway if we get it. The Trailblazers moved to 6-0 with another come-from-behind victory. So, Coach, it's been good. Having a good time with you.
We're good.
Be back tomorrow night and watch the Lady Trailblazers take on. Well, I don't think they're playing tomorrow night. Maybe they were. They may have changed the schedule, but we'll find out.
Right.
But anyway, you've been watching GHS-TV Sports. Trailblazers walk off with another 5-4 victory against Shawnee Mission East and improve to 6-0. Good night. We'll see you next time.